baby, and welcome back, everyone. Welcome back to a new episode on the Primus Mod Sauce server. Do you like this little moonwalk I'm doing? I think it's pretty cool. So guys, you may notice around me some stuff has been getting done. I'm just going to go ahead and get into F5 here and show you the progress I've made on the new base, the new Fantasy Factory. I don't know what we should call it yet, so for the meantime, I'm calling it the Fantasy Factory. But look at this, guys. Bum, 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 bum. Here, I'll zoom back a little bit. And yeah, I took a little time yesterday and tried to at least create the front of it and the inside. It's going to be a continual work in progress. So this is the kind of the front. The portal will lead you into it. I think what I'm going to have to do with this portal, unfortunately, when I go through the portal, it shoots me this way. And that is a very uninspiring view. Actually, it's pretty good. Look at all those beautiful trees, and there's like some crazy lizard monster down that way. But what would be really cool is if when people came out of the portal, they saw this. Like, that was their first thing they see. And maybe with a couple... Another thing I want to do is grow a couple more of those giant trees over there. So yeah, this would be really cool if I could get the portal to switch around. I'm not positive if it can do that, or if I have to just kind of remake it a few times and see what happens. Yeah, so let's take a look inside here real quick. So basically, I just kind of made the front and the ceiling. Believe it or not, this is not the whole thing. I'll show you here real quick. This is just the first floor. There's going to be, I think, 3 main levels to it. And they're going to stack like layer cakes. So the second layer will look a lot like this first layer, just smaller and on top. And then I've got kind of plans for maybe some sort of visual spectacle on top. So yeah, I think that's going to look really cool. And let's go in here real quick and I'll show you the inside. I used a lot of this elf glass from Batania, and one thing I realized is that it produces its own light. So it actually turns out to be a really good light source. So these windows are all producing light. And, you know, the elf glass, when you tile it together, has these weird little funky patterns to it, which looks double nice in itself. I also put a little bit of the elf glass on the roof to light up the roof so you could see that as well. I'm also using the chandeliers from Extra Utilities to try to keep some of the mob spawns down. But what I'm realizing with this build is that I'm going to need a lot of items to do it quickly. So far, these walls are all stone, but there is an item. If we look it up here, it is called the Exchanger. And there's 3 of them. They are from Endertech. And these things kind of work like, the Wand of Equal Trade in Thaumcraft. And basically they swap out blocks. So this would be really helpful to have. But we got to build some stuff in the meantime. One thing we're definitely going to have to do is we're going to have to get some Enderium going. So I want to make the top tier one. I want to make the Resident Exchanger. So that is going to require Enderium ingots. It's going to require a resonant flux capacitor. It's going to require pyrithium dust and all that good stuff. And we got to make ourselves a tesseract. So yeah, let's get busy doing that. And yeah, then we can swap out these blocks a lot quicker. We can also do the floor really fast that way. So yeah. I'll show you guys another quick... Let's do like one of these kind of fly overviews of it. I think this looks really cool. Oh my god, I'm so pleased with it. And those protrusions on the top are me marking out where the second floor is going to be. So yeah, those are going to be... It's going to be kind of another layer on top and then a super majestic kind of visual display on top of that. I have the clouds turned off, but I think the cloud layer is like right about here. So yeah, this is where the cloud layer will be. And yeah, so let's get to making that exchanger real quick, and maybe if we get it done this episode, we can play with it. So, yep, another thing that has happened since you guys saw me last is we have updated the server. We're now running the latest stable version of Mod Sauce, but I'm going to use the word stable very loosely. Apparently, there's something wrong with the farming stations. These guys do not accept energy at the moment. I've tried a bunch of different things and, you know, I've messed with the configs and everyone else on the server is having the exact same problem. Farming stations just don't work. they do not accept power. So I think we're going to have to do something with the config file or something like that to get them working. This one still has energy in it, and that's why it's in there. This thing runs very slowly. So this is one working, but it is not getting new power. What's his name? Rage was still having trouble with his as well. It is empty, even though it is hooked up to his power tesseract. And who else? This is Infuegos, and his is out of energy too. So yeah, the farming stations aren't working for us. There's a couple other things that happened, but so far, not so great for me, because my main energy source comes from carrots. So carrots and cakes are what I'm like powering my base with. So the farming station going down is kind of a cramp in my style. And we want to get that fixed eventually. If not, we'll just move on to a different kind of farm. But I really like these Ender IO farms. So, it's just how it goes. I don't need a ton of energy at the moment, so it's not a big deal. We can probably subsist off these cakes for energy for quite a while. So, what were we doing? We were making a resident exchanger. Let's see here. We actually have already gotten fairly started off on it. I started melting down some what do you call this stuff? The liquid ender eyeballs, whatever it's called. And I made myself a pulverizer, made myself an induction smelter, magma crucible. I guess the first thing we can do is go ahead and make ourselves some of that blazing pyrithium. Let's just make an absolute crap ton of it. Let's go grab some redstone from up here. I think I also need, what else do I need? So it takes sulfur, I think coal dust, and blaze powder. The one thing I don't have a crap ton of is blaze powder. I've got a lot of blaze rods, and I'll go ahead and turn these into blaze dust. So yeah, we've actually got a fair amount. I take that back. So let's just make a lot of this. I think it's just like that. Boom, there we go, stack and a half. And as soon as we get some more blaze rods, we can make more, but I think this will hold us for a while. So with that, let's look up. It's been so long since I've made Enderium dust. I'm sure it's not too terribly difficult. Well, that's Enderium. Let's type in blend and see what we get here. Here we go, Enderium blend. So it takes some pulverized tin and pulverized everything basically. So let's get the pulverizing, shall we? Shall we? So I've got some shiny ingots here. We can pulverize those, and we've got some tin. If we throw them in here, I think this will pulverize them into the right thing. We'll do the shiny ingots first, because I think we need more of that than anything. I know we need to figure out a way to get more of this, and I should check my quarry chest, because there might be some shiny metal in here. Oh, look at all this shiny ore. Let's go ahead and smelt that crap. So we'll go ahead and throw this in here and get it good and smelting, just in case I need any more than, you know, the little bit I have here. So that's 20, 21. That'll do us pretty well. Let's go ahead and throw the rest of this tin in here as well. We can get it going. I think the next thing we need are buckets of this ender juice. Delicious ender juice. So let's see, are you done yet? You're getting there. Let's go ahead and grab this. And let's go grab a dis. Wait. Okay, so it's doing the tin now. I don't think I need a ton of this. Let's see here, where'd you go, tin? Is this what tin looks like? Wow, weird. Okay, let's see if we can shift click some of this crap in. So let's use this thing, right? Let's look at the Enderium blend. Oh, it only takes one, it takes more tin than it takes anything. So yeah, let's do that. And we'll put 38 there, and we'll do that. Wait, what'd I do wrong? Tin powder, silver metal. Is there one more thing that I'm not thinking of? Silver dust. Oh, okay. Sure, why not? That is nothing that I expected. All right, silver dust. Silver ingots, come here, you. I must grind thee into other things. Here we go, silver dust in your face. So we need more tin than we need anything. So it's good that we got that done. We'll go ahead and put that into place. Let's see here. It's not there. I wonder if I'm just not remembering that recipe right, and if silver was in there the whole time. Not positive. I think it was just tin. All right, there's our silver. Cool, we haven't made this in probably a good couple of months. So there's one. There's one. And there's that. Cool. So let's throw these into our induction smelter. We've got our hardened glass for our tesseract sitting right there. So if I put 12 of this... Hey, does this not go in here? I wonder if I need like a souped up induction smelter to even make this stuff. Holy crap, that might be what it is. So let's look here. Let's go induction smelter. All right, let's actually go, let's do Enderium and see what we need. Maybe I'm just not remembering it correctly. All right, Enderium ingot. If we back click on it, we need 8,000 RF. Yeah, I might have to upgrade my induction smelter because it is not accepting Enderium blend at the moment. Okay, guys, I'm gonna pause it here and I'm gonna work on upgrading. Hold on, it just went in there. I think we just might be dealing with server lag. What the heck just happened? Is it in there? It is in there. Okay, never mind. I guess that was just some weird tick server lag thing. Oh, you gotta love mod packs. Okay, so there's our Enderium blend getting cooked up. Wonderful. We're gonna make some more. And yeah, baby. So let's put this here. We need more buckets. We need more buckets of stuff. I don't see any buckets anywhere, so we'll just keep doing this. Cool. So yeah, we might be able to make this thing in this episode, I think. Enderium wasn't as hard as I thought it was going to be. Alright, so there's 12 more. If we shift-click it in, it seems to go in pretty easy. So here's 8 Enderium ingots. One thing I did make in between episodes was this redstone flux capacitor, which I think now we can upgrade to the big deal. The Resonet. Where you at, Resonet? Here it is. So it requires 2... Blah, blah, blah. We might have all of... No, we don't have any redstone. Shoot! Redstone! Bane of my existence, where are you? I'm gonna have to make me some more redstone soon. Boom! And I don't think this is going to stack, but we can click like that. And do some of this. Do one of these. And where'd it go? Here it is. And 2 ingots. And we've got our resonant flux capacitor. I think I want to make another one of these eventually and do something. But what else did we need? We needed a tesseract frame. And this shouldn't be too hard, right? 4 Enderium ingots, hardened glass, and a diamond. I think we got all that junk. Let's do that real quick. Where'd you go, tesseract frame? All right, let's see if we can shift click this in. There it is. Boom, tesseract frame. And I think we gotta fill that with goo. So if we find our liquid transposer, we put that there. And then I think we can maybe shovel some of these buckets right into the thing. Oh, let's do it this way, I guess. Is it just not working? There we go. For some reason, we have to shift-click these things in for at the moment, and I don't know why. Oh, it's doing it. It's just not updating the graphic, it looks like. All right, can we put you in here now and do it this way? Okay, I think that's enough resonant ender to fill this thing up. So, what else do we need for the tesseract? We need silver and bronze. I think we have some bronze here. And we should have silver already. Oh, we have lead. We don't have silver, we have lead. Oh my god! Here we go, silver. Maybe we can... Yeah, we got it! We got it, baby! Give me that! Tesseract frame. Let's turn this into a happy and friendly tesseract. Toot sweet. Let's do this one. Boom, we got the tesseract frame. So what's next? What else do we need? We need an ender eye. And 2 ingots. Oh man, we can make this right now, baby. I hope we have like, so we can't do it that way. We'll just shift it like that. All right. Man, I'm so pleased. I thought this was going to be a pain in the butt, but everything seems to have fallen into place. All right, guys, resident exchanger. Now, earlier in the day, I threw a bunch of cakes into this thing, and this is fairly charged up, but let's throw this in here. Oh, is this not going to accept? All right, let's try something else. We have some of this stuff. If I shift-click this in, will that accept power? Oh, it's charging. It's just going pretty damn slow. So, guys, I'm going to let this charge up a bit, and we'll be right back. Oh, hey, I wanted to tell you guys one thing here real quick. Let's go to the chat log. As you guys can see, Monkey Puzzle has joined the server. Hello, Monkey Puzzle. I'm going to yell at him. Monkey Puzzle is a new member of the server. You guys go watch his channel. He's damn amazing. Just go do it. If you don't, you do not know how to live your life. So yeah, there, I said it. Go watch Monkey Puzzle. He's the bomb. And I'm going to all caps him for the rest of this thing. Yes. So, oh wait, it's already charged up. Holy crap, that happened a lot quicker than I thought. Let's see here. Oh, can I pull it out now? Well, let's just go ahead and pull it out now. I'm yelling at you. All right, guys, let's go to our base and try out this resident exchanger dealy-do. Oh, look, now it's daytime and you guys can see it in the daytime in its glory, in its full glory. I'm actually happy with how the roof came out. I think this, it's a little repetitive, but I like it a lot. It almost looks like, what do you call it, rib bones or something? Here we go. Alright, so, let's grab ourselves some bricks. Boop, boop, boop. Let's grab a bunch of bricks, screw it. Let's fill up our damn inventory with bricks and maybe clear out some of this garbage that I picked up while making this damn thing. Okay. More bricks, please. Thank you. All right. So I've got all these bricks, and actually, I want these bricks to be something else. One of the patterns that I like in the fantasy block chisel set is this one, Weird Fantasy Brick. It actually makes for a really good floor, and it doesn't have the block top to it. I don't know how to explain it better than that, but let's just grab ourselves a few stacks of these here, and maybe we can get to making a floor. A floor would be super nice and super great, and that's what I want. Okay, so I think we have to put the block down, right? So if we put the block down and maybe click it with this. Oh, there we go. Radius 3. Can I make radius go higher? Middle click. Oh man, how do I make radius 3. Okay, so that's not bad. I wish it was higher, but let's do this. And let's give this a try here real quick. Whoa, that is awesome. Oh my Lord and God. So that will definitely save us some time, gentlemen. And honestly, the whole floor is not gonna be this brick. I'm gonna break it up with some patterns and stuff, but look at this. This is heavenly. I wonder if I can expand the radius of this. I really like how it shows me how much of this block I have in my inventory. That is the tits, I think. Now, I wonder if this goes outside. We should check outside and see if this goes beyond a perimeter. I'm not positive that it does. It doesn't seem to. No. So cool. This thing's kind of smart. I love it when things are smart, or when they are actually, when they're actually smart instead of like dumb, stupid, smart. Okay, so cool. Well, guys, I think we got that done, and we're gonna finish. Next episode, we'll probably finish out these walls and maybe make ourselves a magnum torch for the inside of the base. And when that's done, I think we can start moving stuff in. I think we can start moving stuff into our fabulous Liberace palace. This thing is my modest house. Wait till you guys see my real pimp house. It is gonna blow your tits off. I tell you what. So guys, as always, I want to thank each and every one of you handsome and gorgeous people for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, give it a big old thumbs up. And until next time, guys, we'll see you all real soon. Goodbye!